Easter, everyone. This is one of the greatest days ever. We get to remember Jesus' crucifixion and celebrate that after 3 days, he rose again. So turn to a family member and shout, "He is risen," and get ready to learn more in this video. Smash that egg. In this game, Todd and Johnny will choose a numbered egg for each other, and you guys at home will have to guess if it's hard-boiled or raw. And we're going to smash these eggs on their heads. Let's go. What egg do you choose for Johnny?
I'm choosing, let's go number 5.
Okay.
I don't like the number 5.
Okay. Let's smash. Hard boiled.
Hard boiled. Almost not hard boiled.
Yeah,
that was kind of
soft.
That was probably soft.
Okay, Johnny.
Yeah, Johnny.
What egg do you choose for Todd?
Choose a good one, Johnny.
I feel like the best egg that Todd would appreciate the most is number one.
Number one. I like that. I'm number one
on the noggin.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh! You redeemed him. You just lit
it's
him.
Like I'm a bat.
It's lit off. I tried not to get on your shirt. It just kind of went off.
I think you made it worse by trying not to get on a shirt.
Let's go 9.
Okay, ready?
No.
Another
ride!
Out of paybacks, John.
Man, I honestly can't tell a difference between these eggs when I pick them up.
They feel the same when they
do. Okay.
They only feel different when you get the cold splash.
You know, the number of perfection in the Bible is 7. I think we go with number 7.
Okay.
Oh.
Let's see. Already.
Hard blown wrong.
Nothing even happened.
No,
hey, can we amplify that sound effect that happened?
I don't want to hit it harder.
Come on, Lydia, just give it to me.
It's hard boiled.
That one sounded like it hurt.
Yeah. Okay.
Flashing up in my mind is when Johnny dressed up as a baby. We called him Baby Johnny. I'm gonna go with number 2.
What does that have to do with it?
I think he just wanted to bring up Baby Johnny.
I think he just wanted to bring that up.
Okay, number 2.
Oh! Yes. Was that hard boiled?
No, that was raw.
That was raw? That's not raw. That's not hard boiled.
Ow. It's so good for your hair though. It's nice and shiny up there.
You just gotta spread it around. Last egg.
I wanna go with.
Come on, Johnny, think hard.
Todd starts with the letter T, so let's go with 10, which also starts with the letter T.
That's a good one. I have a good feeling about this one.
Okay.
You better.
Last one. Let's see.
Okay.
Oh. Get that away from me.
Johnny is falling off.
Keep that over there. All right, this round we're doing 2 eggs, so put in your guesses. Hard boiled or raw?
Okay, ready? Let's smash it.
Why do you do that? Oh, so hard. Was that both hard boiled or what was mine?
Mine was raw.
Definitely
yours
raw.
Yours is hard boiled.
Mine's not raw. I see the raw. Ew.
It smells.
It does smell.
Thanks for playing, everyone.
Ew. Johnny, please tell me you got towels.
The question, why do we use Easter eggs? Easter is one of the most important dates on our calendars. We remember Jesus' crucifixion and celebrate his resurrection. But why the eggs? Well, did you know that eggs are a great picture of the Easter story? They point us towards the new life that we receive from the resurrection. On Easter, we celebrate the greatest miracle that ever happened. That's why our big idea is Jesus died on the cross to save us from our sin, and he is alive. When Jesus died on the cross, he did it for us. Our sin carries very heavy consequences. We deserve separation from God forever because of our sin. Jesus took those consequences for us when he died on the cross. His sacrifice was perfect and enough to save us. Why don't we watch our story to find out more together?
Jesus and his disciples came to Gethsemane. Jesus prayed, "Father, if it is possible, take this suffering away from me, but only if it is part of your plan." While Jesus prayed, the disciples fell asleep. Jesus said, "Get up, it is almost time." Suddenly, Judas arrived with a large crowd. Judas kissed Jesus so the crowd would know who Jesus was. The crowd arrested Jesus. Peter tried to stop the men. but Jesus told Peter to stop. Jesus' followers ran away, but Peter stayed nearby. 3 times, Peter was asked if he followed Jesus. No, Peter said. Jesus was led to the high priest. The religious leaders tried to find a reason to kill Jesus, but they could not. The high priest asked, "Are you the Messiah, the Son of God?" Jesus replied, "Yes, that's right." The high priest said, "Aha, he has spoken against God. He deserves to die." The religious leaders did not want to believe Jesus was God's son. When morning came, the religious leaders led Jesus to Pilate, the governor. "Are you the king of the Jews?" Pilate asked. "Yes, that's right," Jesus replied. "What should I do with Jesus?" Pilate asked the crowd. "Crucify him," they answered. Pilate did not think Jesus had done anything wrong, but he handed Jesus over and said, "Do whatever you want." The governor's soldiers put a scarlet robe on Jesus. They put a crown of thorns on his head. Then they mocked him. "Here is the king of the Jews." They beat Jesus and led him away to be killed. The soldiers nailed Jesus to a cross. They put a sign above his head that said, "This is Jesus of Nazareth, the king of the Jews." 2 criminals were crucified next to him. Darkness covered the land. Jesus cried out, my God, why have you forsaken me?" Jesus shouted again with a loud voice, and then he died. Suddenly, the curtain in the temple sanctuary split in two from top to bottom, and there was an earthquake. One of the men guarding Jesus' body said, "This man really was God's son." Jesus was buried in a tomb. A stone was sealed in front of the tomb so that no one could steal Jesus' body. On the 3rd day, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to the tomb. Suddenly, there was an earthquake. An angel of the Lord rolled back the stone and sat on it. The guards were so afraid that they fainted. The angel spoke to the woman, "Don't be afraid. I know you are looking for Jesus, but he is not here. He has been resurrected, just like he said he would. In fact, he is going ahead of you into Galilee." The women left the tomb quickly. They ran to tell the disciples the good news. Just then, Jesus met them. "Good morning," he said. The women worshiped him. "Don't be afraid," Jesus told them. "Go tell my disciples to meet me in Galilee. They will see me there." The crucifixion and resurrection of Jesus is the center of the gospel. We deserve to die because of our sin, but Jesus died in our place. He was the blood sacrifice made once and for all for the forgiveness of sin. God was pleased with Jesus' sacrifice and raised Jesus from the dead to reign as king over all creation. We are forgiven only through Jesus.
As we have learned today, our sin carries a huge consequence. Because of our sin, we are separated from God forever. So let's use this little guy to represent us. And let's use this dyed water to represent our sin. This is why Easter is important to us. We celebrate that Jesus didn't only have the power to conquer death, but also our sin problem. Did you know that the Bible calls Jesus the light of the world? Let's use this to represent Jesus. The Bible tells us that on the cross, Jesus took up our sin. You see, Jesus didn't come to earth just to perform miracles. He came to rescue us from sin. He took our sin on himself and he went to the cross, putting our sin to death and offering us forgiveness and life in God's kingdom. On the 3rd day, Jesus came back to life. God was so pleased with Jesus' sacrifice that he raised Jesus from the dead. And Jesus is still alive today. If Jesus had died and stayed dead, it would have been like any other person's death. God raised Jesus from the dead to show his death was enough to pay the consequence of our sin. When we trust in him as our Lord and Savior, we can be with Jesus forever. He forgives the sin that separated us from God. He places our old sinful lives with the new lives that are made righteous because of Jesus' perfect obedience. Go ahead and close your time by reading through our story found in John chapter 20, verses 1 to 18, and then spend some time in prayer. Thank God for sending his son Jesus to live a sinless life, dying on the cross and rising from the dead to save us. Thanks for watching, everyone. Happy Easter, and join us next week when we can learn how Peter performed miracles.